Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied the deviation from ideal gas behavior, and from there where we have learned that the gases which show a deviation from ideal gas behavior are basically known as real gases, or those gases which can be compressible. But yes, there were some gases that were not being compressible. So now based on that, we are not going to talk about what is compressibility factor. So let us talk about it. So now talking about compressibility factor, it means it is defined as the ratio of product of pressure and volume, that is PV, for a gas to nRT. Means it is a basically it is a ratio of PV and nRT. So it has been represented by the symbol Z. So we could write it as Z is equals to PV divided by nRT. So this is something that we follow, that is Z is equals to compressibility factor, which is equals to PV divided by nRT. But yes, for ideal gases, what we have, we can write in this manner, that is Z is equals to PV, in this case, because it has been related with volume, because we know that in ideal gases there will be no change in volume while compressing it. So I am keeping the volume the same, or I will define it as V ideal divided by nRT. But Z is equals to 1 for ideal gas. This is because if we know that ideal gas equation, that is PV is equals to nRT, and if we want this equation to be PV is equals to nRT, that means the value of Z should be 1. So in that case, what we have got is as PV, which is basically in this case the PV is equals to ideal, which is equals to nRT. So this is what we have got. So PV is equals to nRT. So now talking about the next one, that is when we are talking about a real gas. So for real gas, again the compressibility factor, that is the value of Z, will be Z is equals to PV divided by nRT. So in this case, the volume can be reduced because we are talking about real gases, and in the real gases what happens is the gas can be compressed because the intermolecular force of attraction is can be more if we try to compress those gas molecules with each other, or if we'll increase the pressure. So in that case, what happens is they behave like real gases. So I am mentioning in this way. So in that case, what happens is PV is equals to ZnRT, and this is for real gas. So I am keeping this equation as equation 2, an initial equation that we have did earlier for, that is for ideal gases. I am letting this equation to be equation 1. So in this case, both as we could see, that is nRT is the common factor that we could see, that is Z nRT. So what happens is now we are going to compare these two things, that is equation 1 and equation 2. So therefore, equating 1 and 2, what we get is, suppose if we are dividing in this way, that is PV real divided by PV that is ideal that we have got, which is equals to, because for real we have a ZnRT, and for that for ideal gas we have just nRT, because in that case Z is equals to 1. So this is nRT. So what happens is this all will cancel out each other, even P will cancel out each other, and in that case what will happen is Z is equals to, that is PV real that we have got, and the whole divided by P V ideal, and in this case P will cancel out each other, so therefore Z is equals to basically P V of real divided by V of ideal. So this is the value of the compressibility factor we have got. So even this is a formula where we could estimate that what is the compressibility factor of a particular gas if it is following or of a real gas. and we have a volume of the ideal gas, suppose. So in that case, we could easily calculate what will be the value of the compressibility factor. So now talking about in more advanced, if we see, if we initially we have did a lecture that was on the deviation of the from the ideal gas behavior. So that what we have observed is that for gases like H2 and helium, as the pressure goes on increasing, what happens, the more they deviate from the ideal gas that we have curve, ideal gas curve that we would say. So in that case, the more the pressure we apply, then the thing is they won't be compressed and they will behave like they will deviate away from the ideal gas, and yes, that makes them uncompressible for H2 and for helium. But while for talking about the carbon monoxide and CH4 gases, so in that case what happens is the they show negative deviation from the ideal gas equation, and yes, at a particular point or at a specific pressure, they can be compressible, and even though if we increase the pressure, so what will happen is they won't be compressible. So that is the thing for carbon monoxide and CH4. So now talking about this thing, that is Z is equals to V real and divided by V is equals to ideal. This is also the thing that we could describe, and let me give you a short example of that, so that we could how can we estimate by deducing the value of Z, whether that can be compressible or that cannot be compressible. So suppose if I say that if Z is equals to 1, suppose in any case, suppose if we have got the value of Z is equals to 1, so it is clearly indication that that gas would be the ideal gas, that is fine. So what happens when the value of Z is less than 1? So suppose if the value of Z is less than 1, so taking the reference of this thing, so Z will be less than 1 when, if the volume of real gases is less than the volume of the ideal gases. So if the volume of real gases is less than the volume of ideal gases, so that makes the value of Z less than 1. So that means if the value of Z is less than 1, that means we could say clearly that the volume of real gases will be less than compared to that of the volume of ideal gases. If the volume of real gases will be less compared to that of the ideal gases, this makes a clear indication that the gas can be compressible. So therefore, it is very much clear to understand, and because of this equation only we could understand it very clearly, that if Z is less than 1, then the gas will be compressible. And what if for Z is more than 1? Taking the reference of this again, so if Z is more than 1, that means what will happen is the volume will the volume of the real gas will be more than compared to that of the volume of the ideal gases. That means if volume of the real gases will be more, then what happen is we can't compress it, because so to compress those gas molecules, we need those gas molecules to come very close to each other, and this will only happen if they come with close to each other, and the force of intermolecular attraction if it increases. But the main factor is, if the volume increases, then the distance will also increase between the two gas molecules, and there will be no force of attraction between those two molecules. And yes, this will let us to know that the gas will be not real gases, but yes, that gases won't be compressible, and because of the increase in the volume that we could see. So suppose if Z is more than 1, this clearly indicates that the V real will be more than compared to the ideal gas, and yes, we could clearly indicate that if Z is more than 1, then it is non-compressible. So this is the thing that we have got to know. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to know that by estimating this values of Z, we could easily predict whether the gas is compressible or not, or whether the gas is behaving ideal gas, like an ideal gas. So thank you friends for watching this video. Yes, share this video with friends, and I hope you have understood this video, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.